Hello everyone, I'm Matt, and this is the worst channel on YouTube. This is my series on my interpretation of Buddhism, which I call centrism, and if you enjoy, please consider subscribing. Be sure to watch the earlier episodes too to get the full picture, but with that said, we'll just get right into it. So first off, I want to say that, at least for now, this is going to be my last video in this particular format, going over the basic ideas of centrism in such a, you know, academic and structured format. Yes, I'm still going to make Buddhist videos because I still have things to talk about, but this particular format is getting a little stale, I think, and so I'm going to try and let these 10 videos just stand on their own sort of mini-series. But also these videos seemed a bit preachy, which was not my intention, because again, I'm not the expert and I'm still learning, so, you know, I figured a different format was in order. Now, I'm still working on what I want to make next when it comes to Buddhism, so stay tuned, and I'm open to ideas. Leave your thoughts in the comments. Anyway, because I'm ending this particular series, I thought I'd make one video kind of summarizing the highlights between centrism and traditional Buddhism. But also remember, we all are impermanent beings, including myself, so my mind is always open to change, so this may not be a permanent list. The first and most major difference is the emphasis. See, all schools of Buddhism in existence today emphasize different parts of the Buddha's teachings, and this is what primarily sets them apart from each other. For example, the Theravada tradition emphasizes strict monasticism and adherence to laws. The Tibetan tradition emphasizes rituals, magic, and spiritual advancement. And Zen Buddhism stresses meditation above all else, etc. There are many different schools with different emphasis in different areas, but in this vein, centrism stresses one principle above all other things, the idea of balance. Extremes tend to be evil, while moderation tends towards good. Everything we do and everything we are must be viewed through this lens, and therefore balance, or the middle way, is the central guiding tenet of the religion. All things must be balanced and viewed through this lens. This extends into areas that traditional Buddhism shies away from. For example, lying. Saying that all lies are immoral is an extreme and is wrong. For example, lying to keep a surprise party secret is actually a moral act. It is the intention and outcome that makes or breaks the morality of an action, and thus balance is always needed. Another example is killing. Everything needs to kill to survive, no matter what you are, so killing in some instances must be moral. Another instance of balance is when it comes to the supernatural. Some people find comfort in worshiping gods, and for them this brings happiness, which is ultimately the goal of Buddhism. As long as one remembers that nirvana cannot be granted by gods, and that it is up to each individual to free themselves from samsara, there's nothing wrong with it. Also, this is true of rituals, magic, ceremonies, etc. These things may be of great psychological power and impact, and Buddhism is ultimately about psychology, so there's nothing wrong with doing them. However, when it comes to the term, quote-unquote, supernatural, I say there is no such thing. What I mean is that everything acts in accordance with conditioned laws, and so everything can be eventually explained. This does not mean that we currently know everything that exists, and in fact, there are many things we still don't know about. However, all of these things are still part of the conditioned world. This may be too philosophical for some, so if it is, just know what I mean is so-called supernatural things can exist, such as like ghosts or magic or anything like that, but all of these things can be explained, meaning the only things that are supernatural until we can explain them. And since everything can be explained, nothing is really supernatural. Next, and in no particular order, centrism is naturally more culturally Western and specifically American than other branches of Buddhism. I say this only because it's my interpretation, and as I'm an American, I'll naturally put an American cultural twist on things, whether I mean to or not. I don't know of any specifically off the top of my head, but I'm merely acknowledging that this will naturally be a part of things. Now, when it comes to monasticism, I think that the old rules need to be updated to reflect the idea of the middle way for modern times. Buddhist monks today are too ascetic, I think, and this is not conducive towards enlightenment. I have an entire video on this. It's the third episode in my Centrism series, all about monastic reforms, so I won't go in it again, but just know that it's just Buddhist monks today, they live too harshly and they are way out of balance. So beyond these points, there really aren't too many differences between my interpretation and traditional Buddhism, at least when it comes to Zen Buddhism. So I'm not gonna continue to go on with all the different things that I believe and, you know, continue to preach, essentially, because that's not the point of these videos. But, you know, if anything comes up, you know, my thoughts change on different issues, that kind of thing, I'll bring them up in videos as well. But as I said, this is the last one in this particular format. So I hope that that helped clear things up for some people. And, you know, as I said, I'm always open to changing my mind. So leave your thoughts in the comments below. Maybe I'm totally wrong and you think that I'm wrong. And that's one of the purposes behind Buddhism. Buddhism is about having an open mind and thinking about things, not accepting what you're told necessarily, but examining the world for what it is and seeing the truth of things. So with that said, I want to thank everybody again for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this little series. Please consider subscribing for more stuff. I will continue to make Buddhist content, just not necessarily in this format. And yeah, just leave me your thoughts below. I'd love to hear them.